How would you have felt if straight after school you were told it was time to serve your country? Well, that's what the UK Prime Minister has in mind for Britain's youth, and Australia could be next.
If you're not learning or earning, then you are serving.
Young Aussies, beware. Jacqui Lambie wants you.
And I want to speak really, really out there to those kids that are sort of 21 and below. We haven't got the feet on the ground.
The Senator today calling for the establishment of a non-mandatory National Guard made up of young Aussies who aren't working or studying.
I think it's a damn good idea.
People shouldn't be forced to go anywhere they don't want to.
A bit of discipline that I think's lacking, especially in today's day and age.
Her plan? To train up the young recruits in non-traditional missions like helping during national disasters and pandemics.
I don't want to scare you. I just want you to have some skill sets where, especially with national disasters, we can go, hey, guys, 24 hours, grab your packs, go and help out.
Lambie's plan comes off the back of UK Prime Minister Rishi Sunak's pledge to make it mandatory for all 18-year-old Brits to do either a year of military service or 12 weekends of civilian national service, volunteering in their local communities.
This will give all young people valuable life skills, make our country more secure, and build a stronger national culture.
Day in the life on the battlefield. So after waking up to the sound of air sirens, I got myself up and had my morning rations of 8 beans and a slice of bread.
The UK, just the latest in a long line of countries with national service laws in place. Denmark, Finland and Greece all have mandatory service. In Israel, men must serve in the Defence Force for at least 32 months, while women must serve 2 years. And in Norway, everyone's obliged to complete just over a year and a half of military service. So would a similar model fly in Australia, or would the mere thought send younger generations spiralling?
My first reaction was it wouldn't work. I'm not sure whether the young people of today are ready for national service.
We headed down to the battlefield and me and my bestie found this swing. We had so much fun, you know, I had to take some Instagram pictures.
Well, Normie Rowe was conscripted to fight in Vietnam more than 50 years ago and he joins us now. Normie, back then you had no choice when it came to military service. It was literally a marble picked out of a barrel. So what do you think when you hear the UK Prime Minister in 2024 throwing around the idea of national service?
Well, I'm not really surprised. They've never really had any experience with it, especially over the last 50 or more years. So they don't know the detrimental effect that it can have when you're forced into doing something like this. I personally have always disagreed with conscription, with national service, when it has to do compulsorily with military service.
What was it like when you got the call up all those years ago?
I had periods in the first 6 or 8 weeks of knowing that I was going to be going into the army, periods of, I suppose you would call, depression. But as it got closer, I bit the bullet, figured I was going anyway, so I might as well try and do what I could do to get through the whole 2 years, especially when I was going to Vietnam, try and get there safely and not cause somebody else any damage as well.
In the case of Rishi Sunak's suggestion, it seemed to apply only to military training, so not necessarily going off to join the army, fight in a war. Does that make any difference in your mind?
Yeah, I think it does. I've said almost all my life that a service to the nation could be a very, very good thing. I think it gives us a sense of who we are. I don't care if it's cleaning up the highways. I don't care if it's helping people who are disabled, older people who need to be looked after. We're very lucky to actually be born in Australia, and it's probably not unfair to be asked to do something that would help us build our nation.
Well, Normie, that sounds a little more like what Jacqui Lambie's talking about, the senator. She's saying, look, you know, it could be like a National Guard, and when we have, you know, a bad flood like we had in northern New South Wales or bad bushfires or whatever, you could have a group of people then you could call on to help out. You'd support something like that?
Yeah, well, you know, what would be really good is the training that the young people get to be able to assist the SES organisations around Australia. I think that could be really worthwhile.
But you'd have to make it compulsory, wouldn't you, Normie? Like, I can't imagine saying to our younger generation, oh, you know what, if you want, you can spend a year picking up papers on a highway. and it'll be great because you'll be doing it for the country. Like, I reckon you'd get take-up of approximately zero.
Imagine saying that to Normie when he was at the height of his pop career. Stop singing pop songs and go and pick up rubbish by the side of the road. You would have told him to get stuffed.
Well, I didn't, so I didn't go to jail. but, you know, it was a very different thing too. I mean, that was wholly and solely to be in the military, to bolster our military forces. We had something like 60,000 national servicemen, half of whom ended up going to Vietnam over that 10-year period, and 523 didn't come home. And when we got back, we were asked to forget. And how can we do that? We couldn't forget our friends. By this time, we had merged together as a group of people who cared about each other's livelihood, our ability to survive.
Times have changed, Normie. What do you think would entice the younger generation to serve their country? Because I feel like the sentiment of being proud of their country isn't as strong right now as it might have been in the past.
You know, in 1967, I went to Montreal, Canada, with the Seekers and Barry Crocker and Don Burrows and George Goller and a whole bunch of other Australians. I came back one night after being at a club in Montreal, only to find all the Australians sitting around singing Waltzing Matilda and The Dog Sits on the Tucker Box and The Road to Gundagai and Riding to the Never Never. Sometimes it takes a moment to wake us up to say, hey, what we've got here is really good. It's really fantastic and really worthwhile sticking our chest up and saying, this is worthwhile doing for our country.
Normie Rowe, yeah. Right. Thank you so much for the chat. And hey, thanks for your service as well. We appreciated talking to you tonight.
Thanks, Sarah. Thank you very much.
There's two different things here, isn't there?
Yeah. Totally different things.
You've got the Defence Forces is short of boots on the ground, and so they need more recruits. But if you're talking about a national service like Jacqui Lambie's talking about, that's a completely different thing.
Do you like it?
Yeah, I don't mind it, actually. I mean, I don't know about... I mean, she's choosing to say if you're studying or you're...
if you're not studying or working...
Not studying or working, you're the one. But it should be for everybody.
I think it has to be, because otherwise...
Yeah. Under 50s or something. We're under 60s.
Over 60s.
Whatever age price he's not, let's do it.
No, because I'd do it. I'd go on.
You're the youngest.
Thank you.
Would you?
No.
It would have to be compulsory,
check my diary. I'm busy. I think I asked a question then to Normie as well. I think the public sentiment of at least my generation is very different. I think because things have been so good that the concept of defending your country is kind of... It's kind
or
of
even serving your country.
Serving your country.
But do you think it's because you haven't had the need to think about that yet?
You
I think
had
so. Exactly. If it came to the crunch, I think we kind of write
China's
a lot of young
on
Australians
the beach
off.
Outside Darwin.
Yeah, I think
if New Zealand invade, I'm in. That's the only country I'll do anything to save us.